Goedemorgen, welkom bij een zendingboodschap en welkom nieuwe vrienden. Good morning and welcome to our missions message and welcome new friends to our missions group. I hope it's warmer up north and perhaps east than here in South Africa. Winter has really set in, but God is going to warm our hearts this morning with a great message, I believe. Goedemorgen vrienden, laat ik beginnen in Afrikaans dan. Vanmorgen gaan het oor die kracht van boe. Soveel keer wil ons dinge in ons eie kracht doen, vooral nou met die pandemie wat uitrek, was ek self een bietjie neerslagtig en het voel net vir my, hier is geen lig in die tunnel nie. En eintlik vanmorgen dan spreek ek vir myself, maar kom ek herinner julle gauw aan Lukas 11 vers 9. Ek sê vir julle bid en vir julle sal gegee word, soek en julle sal vind, klop en vir julle sal oopgemaak word, want elkeen wat bid ontvang, en hy wat soek vind, en vir hom wat klop sal oopgemaak word. En dan weet ons ook van Matteus 6:33, soek eerst die koninkryk van God en sy geregtigheid en alles sal by julle toegevoeg word. Nee, en dan weet ons ook van hy stuk van sit jou hand aan die ploeg en moenie omkyk nie. Sit net jou hand aan die ploeg. Vertrou Godse kracht, dat jy sal voor hem toe gaan. Moet nie omkyk nie. Kom ons bly positief oor die toekomst. Hierdie gaan oor boonatuurlike kracht. En dat ons ons oë moet op God hou. Hy is in beheer en ons weet van waar ons kracht vandaan kom. So, ons moet weer focus op die kracht van bo, as ons wil voor hem toe gaan. This morning then, it is about knowing where our divine strength comes from. I was just saying here in South Africa now, there's new restrictions regarding the pandemic, and even I went through like a bit of a slump the last week, and I was really looking for encouragement. Sometimes it just feels like there's no light in the tunnel, but there is. This is the message today, that we have a God that is in charge, there is hope, there will be an end to this thing eventually, but the message is about we must know where our strength comes from and where our protection comes from. And our strength comes from above. We have to rely more and more on the divine strength, on the strength within us from the Holy Spirit and alongside us. So many times I want to do things in my own strength and I realized how dependent I am on the Spirit strength. And this is the message this morning. Hold on to your faith. Heads down. Just go forward in faith. Believe in the power of the one within you. 1 John 4 verse 4 says, the one that is in you is greater than the one that's in the world. The Holy Spirit within you is greater than the one that is in the world. And also Matthew 6:33 says, first seek the kingdom of God and His righteousness and everything will be added onto you. First seek the kingdom of God and His righteousness and everything will be added onto you. Meaning, seek God's kingdom, the kingdom of spirit, the kingdom of love and grace, but the kingdom of power. God is the source of our power, our divine power. Without that, we can't exist. Without that, we won't get through. But we're going to plow through. Like Jesus said, don't let go of the plow. Leave your hand on the plow and don't look back. We're going to plow through this pandemic with the spirit of the power. The power of the Holy Spirit. We're going to plow through this pandemic. All we need to now do is hold on with faith. Don't let go of this plow. Let God take the steering wheel. Let's put heads down in our families, community and churches. Let's put head down and keep on believing. Stay in a consistent faith. And that is what I want to read and share with you this morning from Luke 11:9. It's about persistent faith. So I say to you, ask and keep on asking and it will be given to you. Seek and keep on seeking and you will find. Knock and keep on knocking and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who keeps on asking persistently receives, and he who keeps on seeking persistently finds and to him who keeps on knocking persistently, the door will be opened to you. I like the amplified version here, repeating the word persistently all the time. What father among you of his sons asks for a fish and will give him a snake instead of a fish? Or if he asks for an egg, will give him a scorpion? If you then, believing, know how to give good gifts to your children, how much more will your heavenly Father give you the Holy Spirit to those who ask and continue to ask him? I must repeat that, that's important. How much more will your heavenly Father give the Holy Spirit to those who ask and continue to ask him? We're serving a great God. We're serving Jehovah Jireh, our provider. He's the provider of our strength. So this message for me is about first prayer and then a provision and then persistent or constant faith, I want to call it. I like the logic of Jesus here. He first begins with ask. Keep on asking, it will be given to you. So there's an importance in the logic there, and then seek and then knock on the door. So we can't find a door. We can't find a door to knock on unless we first pray about it. So the priority is a spiritual priority. We need to know where our divine power comes from. Our divine power comes from above. The Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit within and alongside us. God is a source of supernatural power. God is the source of the divine power that we will need to plow through this pandemic. The Holy Spirit within and alongside us is our supernatural power that will empower you and protect you so we can plow through this pandemic to go forward. Don't look back. It's a bad habit to look back. Look at the present and look at the future. Jesus said that we will have hard times, but he has overcome the world. He said we will have hard times. It's realistic. We will have challenges, but Jesus also said and promised he has overcome the world. And in Jesus, we are victorious. In Jesus, we are overcomers because we know where our power and strength lies. In Father God's love, grace, spirit. So my friend, I wonder this morning to encourage you not to give up. Grit faith, active faith, just head down, pray, and then this persistent faith, and then also praise. Praise is important. During the last week or two, I did struggle with a bit of depression because of the new curfew rules in our country regarding COVID, and it just felt like a never-ending story. And I got a request to encourage people this Sunday, and I think this morning I am even more preaching to myself, encouraging myself. So I really hope, brother and sister, you find encouragement out of the Word of Life. The bread of life, Jesus Christ himself, and the power of the Holy Spirit. But here's the thing. So after a lot of meditation, prayer, and the word, digesting the power of the word of life, the bread of life, Jesus himself, I started praising God. I started praising God that he is Jehovah provider. He will bring back joy into my life, that he will give me hope. And the more and more I realized how little I rely on his strength. And that is his message this morning. And I'm preaching to myself here. I must learn and start relying on the power of the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of God, daily, more and more. I have to surrender to Father God, the Holy Spirit, more and more. I must digest the bread of life, the Logos, Jesus Christ, word, the truth that sets us free and empowers us every morning. More and more. I must rely and surrender to the Spirit of God, the Holy Spirit, more and more within me and alongside me. That is the only way I'm going to plow forward in active faith. So I want to remind you today where your power comes from, and your power comes from above, divine power. Keep on praying. Have constant faith. Pray. Do read the word and then keep on praising God for your outcome, thanking for Him for the outcome that He's going to provide. And know that Jehovah is your provider. Jehovah Jireh is your provider. And that God is in this thing. Hang in there. Grit down. Head down. Go forward. Look up for your strength, divine strength. And we will get through this pandemic. We will be protected by the blood of Jesus. Know that God is in charge. God is in control. Keep on praying. Keep on asking. Keep on seeking. Keep on knocking. And know where your power comes from. And my friend, if you do not know Jehovah Jireh, Jesus Christ, go on your knees or just after this, say a simple prayer, open your heart and receive Jesus Christ as your only Savior and Redeemer and your only power through the Spirit from on high. Until next time, God loves you. God is taking care of this. And may the Holy Spirit strengthen you and protect you in this time. Shalom. Goodbye. Goeiedag.